Another question we've had, and we've had it a lot, is more information about the whole ancestor thing, how the ancestor part of a query works, what it means, and how to work with it.
Sure, sure. Okay, so yes, I have seen that question a lot, and I'll do my best to answer it. It's Google App Engine specific, the notion of ancestor paths and ancestor queries, but it has a couple of neat things. So the question in the forums was about AskeyChan in particular. And we had a line that looks like this, db.key.fromPath. And then fromPath can take a couple of parameters. And it can actually take, I think, as many as you want. But in this particular example, I just used two. It said like AskeyChan, I'll just abbreviate it AC. And then I think I had the string arts. And so what this does is this actually creates a data store key for an object that doesn't exist. But what I basically said is all of my arts are going to have this parent. And when I created arts, I think when I said something like, you know, like A equals art, and then you'd have all those properties, I guess I could spell them out here. You know, we have title, what did I call it? Actually, like the contents of the art. There's probably another parameter called parent. Parent equals, you know, whatever this key is. You know, we'll call that K. I think it was a function call. What this does is this just stores the art in a database, and it basically says its parent is this key. And the parent is supposed to be another object, but in this case, the object hasn't actually been created. It's just kind of a reference to this fake object. And this is purely for organizational purposes. And there's a couple handy things you can do with this. The first is what I was doing in AskeyChan, which is when you're doing a query, you can say, you know, you have your select statement, or you can do it. You can be doing it procedurally. You know, you know how to run queries at this point. So you store this in a string and you run it, whatever. So select star from arts, and then one of the constraints on this query is where ancestor equals something. In this case, where ancestor equals this K, this key. And what that does is it gives you this property of in DataStore that the query will be consistent. So that means when you've inserted with this parent and then you immediately do a select star, if I didn't have this where ancestor equals K, there's a chance I might not actually get the element I just inserted because of the way DataStore works with this possibly being stored over multiple machines and sharded and all of that. What Google's doing there isn't entirely transparent to us, but one of the things they say in their docs is that if you include this constraint, ancestor equals something, and that happens to be an ancestor of the object you're looking for, the query will be consistent. And so that's all I was doing there. And if you look at the DataStore docs, if you go to that Hello World example in the DataStore docs, it'll actually explain that a little bit, and that's what I was basing this on. Now, this came up again in the final, for doing the wiki. And one of the way that I decided to do the history is I made every page, every path, basically every URL path, like every wiki page in my program, basically be its own path here. And so I would basically just say from path, I think I called it wiki, and then I would actually have the URL. And then each version of the page was another object with that parent. And so when I did a wiki page, you know, if you're just viewing the page, I would just say, OK, get me all of the children of this parent. And I'll take the most recent one to actually show the page. And then when you click on the history view, I just say, get me all of the children of this parent. And that's how I did the version history thing. And that actually made it really easy to do using DataStore. This is a concept that only exists in DataStore, though, this whole parent-ancestor queries where you specify the ancestor thing. So it's actually as new to me as it is to you. But it helps you work around a few constraints that DataStore has. So I hope that helps. There's plenty of information in the Google DataStore docs. And that's what I'm basing most of what I'm telling you on anyway. So I would suggest you check that out.